My dear students, today's topic of discussion is our unit 4, overheads cost control. Let us try to understand the actual meaning of the overheads. Overheads can be defined as the aggregate of indirect material, indirect labor, and indirect expenses. That means overheads is equal to indirect material plus indirect labor plus indirect expenses. Overheads can be classified on the basis of elements, function, behavior, and controllability. Overheads can be classified on the basis of that. See, let us try to understand the basis for apportionment of overheads. Certain items of cost cannot be identified with any particular cost centers or cost units. Such items cannot be allocated. Rather, they have to be apportioned to the various cost centers or cost units by using some suitable basis. See, let us try to understand the basis for apportionment of overheads. So this column is for overheads. This column is for basis of apportionment. Item number one, rent and taxes. Rent and taxes can be apportioned on the basis of floor area. In other words, area occupied. Second important overhead is supervision. Supervision can be apportioned on the basis of direct wages. Next, timekeeping, canteen expenses can be apportioned on the basis of number of employees. So, fourth item is expenses on purchases. Expenses on purchases can be apportioned on the basis of direct material. Depreciation and insurance on machinery or plant and machinery can be apportioned on the basis of value of machinery. So power is always apportioned on the basis of technical estimates. They are horsepower or kilowatts. Lighting is actually apportioned on the basis of light points. If light points are not given, you can apportion it on the basis of area occupied, assuming that more space requires more lights. So indirect labor is always apportioned on the basis of direct labor. Indirect materials can be apportioned on the basis of direct materials. So internal transport can be apportioned on the basis of weight of the packages or containers. So fire insurance premium, this is on building, can be apportioned on the basis of area occupied. Fire insurance on stock is always apportioned on the basis of value of stock. I told that the overheads are classified on the basis of functions. Overheads are classified on the basis of functions. On basis of the functions, overheads can be classified as production overheads. Production overheads are those overheads which are incurred for the purpose of converting the raw material into finished products. Second important classification under functions is office and administration overheads. These refers to all expenses relating to the office administration and management. The following are the examples: office salaries, accounts office expenses, expenses relating to postage, stationery, telephone, etc. This is the second classification under functional classification. Third important item is selling overheads. These refers to the expenses relating to promotion of sales and retaining the customers. For example, advertisement cost, market research and analysis, bad debts, cost of printing the price list and quotation, etc. Fourth important classification is distribution overheads. These include all items of overheads incurred in delivering the product to the customers. For example, packing materials, carriage outwards, repairs and maintenance and depreciation of delivery vans, warehouse expenses, and wastage of finished products. These are the classification of overheads under functions. Now let us try to understand the classification of overheads under behavior. Fixed overheads, variable overheads, and semi-variable overheads. Fixed overheads are those overheads which tends to remain constant irrespective of level of activity, which are not affected by the variation in the volume of outputs. Example, rent of the building, insurance, salary of the office staff, etc. Variable overheads. These include those items of overheads which vary directly with the volume of outputs. Semi-variable overheads. These include the overheads which is partly fixed and partly variable. See, this is the second important classification according to the behavior. Third important classification is that the overheads can also be classified on the basis of functions and elements. Elements, on the basis of elements, you have indirect material, indirect labor, and indirect expenses. Indirect materials refers to those materials or those costs which can be apportioned or to be absorbed by cost centers or cost units. For example, lubricating oil, cotton waste, and other consumable stores, rules, tools, etc. Indirect labor cost is the cost of wages which cannot be allocated but which can be apportioned to be absorbed by cost centers or cost units. Indirect expenses refers to the expenses which cannot be allocated but which can be apportioned to or absorbed by cost centers or cost units.